Good morning, my dear students. Next, young ones to adults. The new individuals which are born or catched from the eggs continue to grow till they become adults. In some animals, the young ones may look very different from the adults. Recall the life cycle of silkworm. On the day I told you, introduction of the lesson சொல்லும்போது metamorphosis example சொன்ன life cycle of frog வந்து example சொல்லியிருந்தேன் life cycle. Like that silkworm, egg, larva or caterpillar and pupa to adult. This is the life cycle of silkworm. Egg to larva or caterpillar or next pupa then last stage is adult. You studied in class 7. Frog is another such example. Observe the different stages of frog starting from the egg to the adult stage. We find that there are three distinct stages, that is egg, tadpole. First stage is the egg, next tadpole. Tadpole is the larva stage, early tadpole and late tadpole. Next adult. Don't the tadpoles look so different from the adults? Can you imagine that these tadpoles would someday become frogs? Similarly, the caterpillar or the pupa of the silkworm looks very different from the adult moth. And the features that are present in the adult are not found in these young ones. Then what happens to the tadpoles or caterpillars thereafter? You must have seen a beautiful moth emerging out of the cocoon. In the case of tadpoles, they transform into adults capable of jumping and swimming. This is the definition for metamorphosis. The transformation of larva into an adult through drastic changes is called metamorphosis. What about the changes that we observe in our body as we grow? Do you think we too undergo metamorphosis? In human beings, body parts similar to those present in the adult are present from the time of birth. Next, asexual reproduction. Asexual reproduction, already first introduction class le ellam solirken. It is a microscopic organism. It can be seen with the help of under a microscope. Adhuma microscope mulam paakudiye tiny organism nadakudiye reproduction vandu namakku kuduthirukanga. Asexual. Example, binary fission in amoeba and budding in yeast. What is binary fission in amoeba? The amoeba inside the nucleus is split into two equal half to produce two daughter amoebae. Parent one amoeba la irundhu two daughter amoebae produce pandradhukku peru dhaan enadhu binary fission in amoeba. Budding in yeast, the body parts la bud form aayi adu mature, full mature aayi then enlarge aanona adu breakdown aayi next further inona form aagu adukku dhaan enna solrom nama budding in yeast. Example of budding in yeast. So far, we have learned about reproduction in some familiar animals, but what about very small animals like hydra and microscopic organisms like amoeba? Do you know how they reproduce? Let us find out. Activity 9.3. Get permanent slide of hydra. Observe them using hand lens or a microscope. Look out for any bulges from the parent body. Count the number of bulges that you see in different slides. Also note the size of the bulges. Draw the diagram of hydra as you see it. Compare it with the figure 9.11. In each hydra there may be one or more bulges. These bulges are the developing new individuals, or they are called buds. Recall the presence of buds in yeast. In hydra 2, the new individuals develop as outgrowths from a single parent. This type of reproduction in which only a single parent is involved is called asexual reproduction. Asexual reproduction definition, then the either may be a male or may be a male. It involves only a single parent, either may be a male or may be a female. Since new individuals develop from the buds in hydra, this type of asexual reproduction is called budding. Another method of asexual reproduction is observed in the microscopic organisms, amoeba. Let us see how this happens. You have already learned about the structure of amoeba. Amoeba have no definite shape. Adhai na erkanave sollirke. You will recall that amoeba is a single cell organism. It begins the process of reproduction by the division of its nucleus into two nuclei. This is followed by division of its body into two, each part receiving a nucleus. Finally, two amoebae, amoeba is a singular, amoebae is a plural, are produced from one parent amoeba. This type of asexual reproduction, in which an animal reproduces by dividing into two individuals, is called binary fission. Apart from budding and binary fission, there are other methods by which a single parent reproduces young ones. You will study about these in your higher classes. Okay, thank you students. That's all, this lesson over. Next class I will give the notes for you. Okay, thank you students.